third year students, welcome back. I hope you all are doing good and taking good care of yourself. So let us start session 2 of the chapter 1, Democracy in the Contemporary World. I hope you have understood the first session very well, and as per the instruction you have gone through the textbook or the PDF that I have sent you and written down the hard words. So let's get started with the session 2. Common features between the Poland and Chile. The people could not choose or change their rulers. There was no real freedom express one's opinion from political associations and organized protests and political action. The three democratic governments were different in their approach towards social and economic matters. Allende preferred government control on big industries and interference. Michel stands somewhere in the middle of this issue, the economy. Valencia wanted to market to be free of government interference. Power was exercised by government elected by the people and not by the army, unelected leaders or any external power. The people enjoyed some basic political freedoms. Democracy. Democracy is a form of government that allows people to choose their rulers. Only leaders elected by people should rule the country. People should have freedom to express views, freedom to organize, and freedom to protest. Democracy has expanded throughout the 20th century. It did not spread evenly in all parts of the world. Democracy was established first in some regions and then spread to other regions. While a majority of countries are democratic today, there are still large parts of the world that are not democratic. Justification against democracy. Democracy is all about political competition and power play. There is no scope for morality. Leaders keep changing in a democracy. This leads to instability. So many people have to be consulted in democracy. That is leads to delays. Elected leaders do not know the best interest of people. It leads to bad decisions. Democracy leads to corruption as it is based on electoral competition. Ordinary people do not know what is good for them. They should not decide anything. Justification of democracy. Democracy enhances the dignity of citizens. Democracy improves the equality of decision making. Democracy improves the quality of decision making. Democracy provides a method to deal with differences and conflicts. Democracy is better than other forms of government because it allows us to correct its own mistakes. A democratic government is a better government because it is a more accountable form of government. The changing map of democracy. Some countries like Britain were already democratic in 1900. Some became democratic in 1950s like India. Democracy expanded rapidly between 1975 and 2000. End of colonialism. For a very long time, most countries of Asia and Africa were colonies under the control of European nations. Many of these countries became democracies immediately after Second World War in 1945. India achieved independence in 1947 and established itself as a democracy. Ghana was a British colony known as Gold Coast. It became independent in 1957, led by Kwame Nkrumah. After independence, Nkrumah became the first Prime Minister and then the President of Ghana. Like Ghana and African nations, after independence also became democracies, but they could not remain democracies for long. After 1980s, democracy was revived in Latin America. The disintegration of Soviet Union accelerated this process, Poland too became democratic. The Soviet Union broke down in 1991. The Soviet Union comprised 15 republics, and all the Soviet republics became independent, and most of them became democracies. Pakistan and Bangladesh also made a transition from army rule to democracy in 1990s. In Nepal, the king gave up many of his powers to become a constitutional monarch to be guided by elected members. By 2005, about 140 countries are holding multiple party elections. Myanmar was one of the countries where the people could not express their views freely. In November 2010, pro-democracy leader Aung San Suu Kyi realized from house arrest, released from house arrest after 15 days. Pro-Jawantha Party, ruling party, won the election with a landslide victory. It was the first election in 20 years. For the first time, Nobel laureate Aung San Suu Kyi stood from parliament and won the election and took oath. She now has an official voice in Myanmar parliament. Democracy of the global level. Democracy at the global level. International organization. There are many international organizations which partially perform the functions of an international government through there is no single world government. Second, examples of international organizations are United Nations, that is UN, in a global association of nations of the world to help cooperation in international law, security, economic development and social equity. The United Nations has six main organs, viz. General Assembly, the Security Council, the International Court of Justice, the Secretariat, the Economic and Social Council, that is ECOSOC, and the Trusteeship Council. The United Nations has succeeded in achieving its primary objective. It has prevented large-scale wars in many areas. There are 17 socialized agencies at the United Nations. Some of the important agencies are International Labour Organization, that is ILO, International Monetary Fund, that is IMF, World Health Organization, that is WHO, United Nations International Child's Emergency Fund, that is UNICEF, UNICEF, etc. UN Security Council is an organ of the United Nations and is responsible for maintaining peace and security among countries. The Council has five permanent members, US, Russia, UK, France and China. International Monetary Fund, IMF and World Bank give money to governments. Present UN Secretary General is Ban Ki-moon, South Korea. Are the institutions democratic? No, these international institutions are not truly democratic because they are dominated by the rich and powerful countries. Smaller and third world countries have very little say in this organization. After the collapse of the Soviet Union, USA appears to be the only superpower. The American dominance affects the working of the international organization. Democracy promotion. USA is a big and powerful country and is also a democracy. It is a self-appointed graduation of guardian of democracy and interference in the international affairs of our countries in the name of strengthening and promoting democracy and dismantling non-democratic forms of government like dictatorship of Saddam Hussein in Iraq. The US elect the Iraq possessed secret nuclear weapons, but when an UN team went to Iraq to search for such weapon, it did not find any. Still, the US and its allies invaded Iraq, occupied it and removed Saddam Hussein from power in 2003. This war against Iraq was actually to gain control over the petroleum product of Iraq. The war was not authorized by UN Security Council, and then UN Secretary General Kofi Annan said that the US war on Iraq was illegal. This is where we end with the second session and the chapter. I hope you all have understood all the topics that are covered. And for the better understanding, as usually, I would say you have to read the textbook, underline the hard words, write them in your notebook 5 times, listen to the videos, read the slides carefully, and you will understand. If any query, do contact me on my personal number so that we can resolve the queries. So stay home, stay safe, take care of yourself. Bye, and see you in next session with question and answers. Till then, take care.